So moving on with your master's or PhD journey in UC Berkeley. So after completing your undergrad at MIT, you plan to do UC Berkeley. So uska karan kya tha? Why you chose UC Berkeley as compared to other prestigious Ivy League schools like Harvard, MIT, Yale, etc.?
I think a PhD is a more sort of personal degree. You get to closely work with your advisor. And I really liked my advisor here, so many people decided that I will join UC Berkeley. But all of them are equally good schools when it comes to my particular area. So undergraduate career or other fields, there is a difference. But especially in theoretical physics, all of them are equally good.
Amazing. And what do you think is expenses for masters and PhD at these top schools like UC Berkeley? I can tell you that at MIT, the expenses are like $20,000 to $30,000 per year, and original expenses are even more, $60,000. So most of the students get assistantships, and after getting those, it cut down to 50%, and then you pay around $20,000 to $30,000. Is that true?
मुझे मास्टर्स का बहुत ज़्यादा आइडिया नहीं है, but that might be significantly more expensive. Usually PhD के साथ आपको स्टाइपेंड मिल रहा होता है. It is basically treated like a job, and so you don't pay anything from your pocket. They usually pay you enough to sort of cover your lodging and boarding, khana peena, ghar wagera. So you don't have to pay anything. And my parents are not contributing right now to any of my educational expenses. Actually, I get paid by the university for the teaching and the research that I do.
Amazing. And same for me. I'm currently doing my master's in computer science, and I'm not paying a single penny. It is fully funded. And on the top of that, I'm getting monthly expenses in monthly income. So it is incredible.
So I think isliye log masters ke liye prefer bhi karte hain, because then it is not a financial burden on you or your parents, I think.
Yep, I agree. But at the same time, PhD, jinhe maine PhD karte hue dekha at MIT, they were definitely paying $20,000 to $30,000, kyunki itni zyada funding nahi hoti. They are considering, they're giving more priority to undergrad, unhe need blind scholarship deni hai. They have to collect funds from somewhere. So that's why it is harder for them to give funding on masters, but PhD ke liye mostly they give.
PhD ke liye mostly they dete hain, zyadatar se ke masters ke liye nahi dete hain. That's also what I believe.
Correct. I absolutely agree. Now, I know when you're doing research, it's kind of stressful, and that depends on professor to professor. Kuch professors aapko bahut zyada kaam dete hain, kuch professor aapko kam kaam dete hain. So, do you get free time out of that, and aap apna health ka khyal pura rakh pate ho? Aapka kitna busy schedule hota hai? Can you describe a day in life of MIT or UC Berkeley student?
So they're very different, you know. Undergraduate is more about like homework. So I used to be much more busier at MIT. In some sense, a PhD, you can treat it like a job. So there is mostly you work 9 to 5, thoda bahut ghar pe aake kaam kar liya, baki you also have to take care of the other things. Ghar pe khana banana ho gaya, shopping jana hua, maybe a little bit of socializing. So a PhD, I would say, is much more like a job. Kuch fields mein ho sakta hai, especially experimental fields mein, ki the hours might be long, but because I'm doing theory, usually 10 hours a day is the upper maxima I might have to put into work, and I usually get the weekends sort of off.
Amazing. And what about back in undergrad at MIT? So how much free time you had?
I was sort of overloading myself because mujhe padhna bahut pasand tha. So I was usually on 6 courses with the average being 4. So mere paas bahut zyada free time nahi tha.
Oh my god. And did you used to like live on campus, food, housing?
I lived on campus, so I did not have to worry about food because dining tha. So matlab yahan pe I have to right now I'm doing much more towards like my household cooking and everything, so none of those responsibilities were on me.
Amazing. Now I want to share that when I visited MIT, I found out that 95% of the students who got into MIT for masters or PhD were IITians. So I want to ask you, like, how a non-IITian can get into MIT? Let's say that I have less research projects, I have low GRE scores. So what should I do today to reach MIT tomorrow? MIT or even UC Berkeley, where you're studying right now for PhD.
I think one clarification, 95% of the Indians are from IIT.
Yeah.
So kya karna chahiye? I think try to do good research. You can always write to professors. You can always matlab when you're applying or before you're applying, you can write to professors and tell them ki tum ye kar rahe ho. Even if you know in your first or second year ki tumko US aana hai ya research karni hai, to try to get into it as soon as you can. Try to work with better people. Sometimes you can find, you know, professors at IIT might be willing to take you for a summer research ship. and instead of doing something else over summer, try to spend it doing better research. GRE again, if your scores are low, I would just recommend keep prepare karne ki aur acche se koshish karo.
Okay. Awesome. So do you think what will make a significant impact, better essay or more research papers? Because that's very debatable as well. So
I would always say ki better research is more important. What the people are looking for is not, especially in science-based fields, they're not looking for, you know, great ability to write language. मतलब वो मेरी इंग्लिश की फ्लावरीनेस को बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं देख रहे, स्पेशली बिकॉज जब आप मास्टर्स के लिए अप्लाई करते हो या पीएचडी के लिए अप्लाई करते हो, तो जो लोग आपका एप्लीकेशन रिव्यू कर रहे होते हैं वो जनरली प्रोफेसर्स होते हैं कंपेयर टू योर अंडर ग्रेजुएट एडमिशन, जहाँ पे वो लोग आर अदर प्रोफेशनल्स हु सॉर्ट ऑफ रिव्यू द होल एप्लीकेंट. सो जब प्रोफेसर्स आपके एप्लीकेशन रीड कर रहे हैं, सो दे कैन लुक थ्रू एंड दे कैन वैल्यू यू ऑन योर रिसर्च रादर देन ऑन योर से राइटिंग एबिलिटी और GRE English score or things like that.
And are you passionate about working out in fun time? So aap free mein kabhi exercising ka time nikal paate ho as a student?
Matlab I think mujhe bachpan se exercising ka shauk nahi raha hai. Mere parents ne hamesha se, that's the only thing my parents sort of had to force me for, was to make me exercise. If you look at my old photos, I used to be like quite hefty and healthy and whatever adjectives you can use. I try to do a little bit now just for my body's sake, but I matlab main usko waise treat karta hu jaise most kids would treat padhai ki matlab majboori hai isliye kar rahe hain.
Wow, it's opposite. Usually hamare parents hame parents it's like opposite. Usually hamare parents hame padhne ke liye force karte hain, aapko workout. It's different culture.
Culture to nahi but ha matlab.
So my question is, as a friend, so mere paas almost 2 research papers honge by the end of my masters. So I'm also planning to do PhD at MIT, UC Berkeley, etc. And I can definitely get 330 plus in my GRE, but it doesn't matter, you already specified. So other than this, I can do best in my essay and reach out professors. So do you think this is enough for me to get into MIT, right? Or for PhD?
Again, so matlab what I should have added was a lot depends on ki aapke recommendation letters kaun likhta hai, for especially for a PhD program. So if your papers are really good and you have decent number of citations and you have good recommenders, then it should not be a big problem. But then again, especially computer science mein, you always need to ask yourself the question ki main PhD kyun karna cha raha hu, and if you don't want to be in academia, the jobs would really not change that much by getting a PhD, I would say.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, if you want to definitely get into research and become a professor, then it'll be
right,
like,
right.
But if I want to, by the end of the day, if I want to do a job, to usse koi farak nahi padega.
Exactly.
Yeah, I agree. So how much do you think a better GRE score will make a better impact towards your master's or PhD application at MIT, Harvard, etc.? Mujhe to lagta hai ki jitni zyada score hogi utna better hoga.
Matlab I would not deny the statement ki jitni zyada score hogi utna better hoga, but the question is ki 135 versus 140 mein kitna difference hai. To what I would say here is ki physics mein ya fir zyadatar pure sciences mein, there is always a subject GRE jo aap likhte ho, and those scores are relatively important. And sometimes if you are going in a math based field, the math score is important, but the math is usually easy to crack for most Indian people kyunki math ka level bahut aasan hota hai. इंग्लिश अपनी कभी इतनी अच्छी थी नहीं, एंड ये ज़्यादातर प्रोफेसर्स को भी पता होता है, उनको भी कोई फ़र्क नहीं पड़ता, हमको भी कोई फ़र्क नहीं पड़ता, और मुझे मेरे जीआरई के स्कोर शायद याद भी नहीं. मुझे इतना पता है मुझे मैथ्स में पूरे आए थे, मुझे इंग्लिश का स्कोर ध्यान भी नहीं है.
Wow, so you can see GRE scores are so unimportant to some extent that he doesn't even remember. And last final tips from your heart, this is the last question, any tips you would like to give to students who want to study anything abroad, so kuch bhi.
I don't want to get too preachy here, but I think one of the main situations that we are facing today as a generation is this social media outbreak. So log apna bahut zyada time mujhe lagta hai ki Instagram pe ya fir Snapchat pe spend kar rahe hain, and that really, you know, dents into the amount of time you have to after school or after other things to put into building a good resume. So I would always recommend ki try to restrict the amount of time you spend on your phone, and try to be, you know, I don't want you to be cut off from social media, but try to keep it at a minimum. And I think recently kafi studies hui bhi hai which have found like especially in America, the amount of depression cases and amount of anxiety cases have like shot up in the past decade just because of social media. So it is good for your mental health, good for your career, both ki aap social media se door rahe. I'm not saying don't watch too much YouTube, but you know, do it in moderation.
Awesome. So thank you so much. It was a pleasure having you here.
Pleasure talking to you as well.
Thank you.